Hi everyone, here in the studio we're going to talk about how to create the connection between WooCommerce and Odoo. So after installing, we are going to the commerce integration module, clicking on you, we need to set up the name of our integration, select the commerce system, my case is WooCommerce, click on save and starting from quick configuration wizard. On the first step we need to stop URLs and keys, so for URL we simply copy from our store. Consumer's key we can take from, we need to go to the WooCommerce, settings, advanced and REST API and click on add key. So we need to set up the description, Odoo, WooCommerce. Here we can see our current user and we need to set permissions, read and write and click on generate API key. So we copy in consumer key and consumer secret. And now additionally we need to set up WordPress user and WordPress user application password. So we are going to the list of our user, find our user, we need to set the name VentorTech and generate application password. It's a bit lower. Here it is. We need to stop any language test order and add new application password, copy and use it. Here it is. Let's go to the next step. Here we are checking that all the necessary permissions are activated on the WooCommerce site. Let's go to the next. Here we're checking what languages we are receiving from WooCommerce and we need to create mapping for them. So we need to set up integration language, in my case it will be English, and create mapping for WooCommerce language to other languages. As you can see, I already have English language, and to activate additional one, I go click on go to languages, activate Polish, and go back to my integration. Here it is. As you can see, mapping was automatically added, and let's go to the next step. Here we need to set up default external taxes. As we know, the structure of taxes is different between WooCommerce and Odoo. In Odoo we have taxes, in WooCommerce we have tax rules. And some tax rules can have multiple taxes. So, for the correct export and import of products, we need to set up default taxes for each tax rules from WooCommerce. So, let's set it up. Here it is. Going to the next step. Here we need to define in what statuses we are planning to receive orders from WooCommerce into Odoo. I can set one status, for example, processes, or maybe additional one completed, or if it's necessary, depending on your business needs, you can set even all of them. Let's go to the next one. And this is the last step. By activating the checkbox, start initial import and clicking on finish, the system will redirect us to the job queue menu. As you can see, we run import of different objects from WooCommerce into Odoo, its categories, features, attributes, and so on. And when all these jobs will go to the done status, that means that these objects will appear in the mapping table and we need to link them. But regarding the initial import, we will talk in the future videos. Thank you.